Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Ramadan Kareem. Inshallah, most likely we are going to start tomorrow Taraweeh. And a lot of questions have been around praying Taraweeh in the light of what's happening. And of course, the lockdown and the pandemic and all these things. How can we pray Taraweeh online? Is it permissible or not? This question has been asked and many scholars have answered it, but I'm going to repeat again in probably a briefer and more concise way. Fard Salat is better to be prayed in Jama'ah, whether in the masjid or with your family. Jama'ah means two people and more, including the Imam and the Ma'moom. If there are more people, family members, it's good. But you must have two adults. It's always recommended. As far as Nafila, supplicatory prayers, you can pray it on your own and preferably on your own. However, one of the prayers that are recommended to be prayed with Jama'ah, even if they are not fard, is Taraweeh prayer. So this you can do it at home with your family. You can pray together if you read the Qur'an. I know many have asked, we do not know how to read the Qur'an and we don't want to make mistakes and we like to listen to the Qari. So what do we do with this? Now, we know from many scholars, and this is the official position of all scholars of all the madahib and all the majami' fiqhiyah, meaning the fiqh councils around the world, that it is not valid, the salat online, meaning following an imam. Now, this is the position, and nobody has that caliber of ijtihad, especially this is a matter of worship. We cannot just innovate and come up with something new. Yes, we are conscious of technology and we understand maybe there will be a time scholars will be able to come together and decide. But at this time, as far as following the imam, there are reasons why it's not allowed, because the imam must be leading you and you should be behind him. If not behind him, behind the last line. If not, you should be able to see the line if you're farther from the last line. Now, there are, of course, exceptions. Scholars from different schools, we're not here to discuss the details. You can refer to our articles posted in Facebook and social media that you can find with details. Now, the most important is fard is something of the pillars of Islam. So you must pray your fard to be on the safe side. Pray your fard with your family, you'll get the reward of Jama'ah. Given the pandemic and given the fact that this is beyond your will, Allah will give you for sure the reward of praying in the masjid if you were a person who always went to the masjid and for you this was part of, you know, your habit to go and pray Taraweeh at the masjid or Jama'ah in general. So when you are not able, as the Prophet taught us, to do something that you used to do, then you get the same reward as if you did it. This is the beauty of Islam, and we should take our religion in an easy fashion, and Islam is the most understanding of our situation, and Allah Azza wa Jal is the most understanding. In the very verses of Ramadan of fasting, Allah says, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرِ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرِ. Allah wants ease for you, and He doesn't want difficulty. So how about Nafila? Now, because the imams, they say the imam should be before you, that means the Qibla is ahead of him. So you have to be behind the imam who's behind the Qibla. We can't guarantee that online, especially in fard. Now, there is leniency and somehow ease with Nafila, because as we know, in Nafila, it's possible that you don't have to face Qibla when you are riding, you know, your horse or your camel or your car. You don't have to face Qibla, and this has been an exemption, and the Prophet used to pray, why not facing Qibla? So that's number one. But following the Imam and following his action, there might be interruption by internet or if you're using audio. Now, of course, there are many examples. People pray in the Haram even without seeing the imam. All these things are arguments. I'm not going to get into them. What I want to stress, why they have this valid, this argument that you cannot pray behind the imam, because you're not seeing him, you're not hearing him, and there is detachment. You're not connected to him. But there is another opinion that says you can follow Jum'ah, Fard Salat, Nafila, and they open. There are even the great late Grand Sheikh Jad al-Haq, Ali Jad al-Haq of Al-Azhar, a renowned scholar, who said you could actually follow even through the radio. Now, these are fatwas, but it's good to stick to the Jama'ah, to the majority. So what can we do? Here is what I suggest for you, very practical way. So inshallah, to balance the issue, not that these are in the extremes, but because we don't have no other option, there is a possibility. So for Jum'ah, for instance, as we've been doing in the last few weeks, and we've been actually airing online since 2009 from this place. So many of you have followed us, have listened to us. But when it comes to Fard, here's what you do. You pray your Fard at home with your family or on your own. For Nafila Taraweeh, when you follow us, inshallah, enter with Niyyah of Fard. And Fard here with Dal means individual Salat. If you want to come out during the prayer, you can, because it's your prayer. And also, you are going to use our qira'at, our recitation, if you want to finish the Qur'an with us, as many of you have expressed the interest to follow us. I say enter as not as a muqtadi, meaning following the imam and doing exactly what he does. And if there is interruption, then you will not able to fix your salat. Here is the better option. And I would say the easier option, rather than using the word better. When the imam says Allahu Akbar, you time your prayer with the imam, but you enter with the intention you're praying by yourself. This way, you're in control of your actions. If you want to come out, if you're tired and you want to finish your salat, or you want to, you lose wudu, you want to go make wudu and come back, all of these things, now you are praying on your own. But you're using the recitation of the imam as if you're reading from the mushaf, the Quran, or you're reading from a phone, or watching, a computer and reading from it. So you're using, so just time the recitation, and you time your movement with the movement of the imam. This way, you have prayed on your own, and you have used the recitation. Now, if you can read the Quran, or you're a hafid, it's better that you pray on your own. If you have a hafid at home, or someone who knows even Juz Amma, or Juz Tabarak, or even Hizb, which is the last half of just Amma, whatever you know, Yasin, Surat al-Kahf, whatever you memorize in your childhood, you can pray with your family and that's fine. You could do it in Jama'ah. But those of you who want to be with us, this is the intention. Allahu Akbar, individual, I'm going to pray two rak'ahs. Allahu Akbar, same time as the imam here in the masjid starts. You have not entered as a muqtadi with the imam here. You have entered with the intention to pray on your own. And you read your Fatiha. Must read your own Fatiha because that is a pillar. While the imam is reading Fatiha, you read Fatiha. And then listen. This would be similar to holding the Quran. I know in Hanafi school, Imam Abu Hanifa did not allow it because for two reasons. Number one, and I'm not going to get into the details, because people might use it for Fard Salat. And secondly, people will compromise memorization of the Quran. And more importantly, there might be too much movement, moving the paper pages and all of that. However, the other two imams in Hanafi school, Imam Abu Yusuf, the judge, Al-Qadi, and Imam Muhammad bin Hassan al-Shaybani, did not see anything wrong with it. In addition, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad are okay with it. And Sayyida Aisha, who is a scholar, a big scholar of this ummah, used to ask the Quran, one of her servants, and he used to read off the Quran, and he had a very good voice, and he would read, and Imam Malik reported, and many scholars that the Sahaba and those who followed them, many of them Tabi'un followers, did actually read from the Quran. So there is nothing wrong, and I take that opinion. It's okay if needed, if a person is not hafid, to read from the Quran. It's not a popular idea, but it's better than, not praying. So for the following, so you pray your Isha Fard with your family or on your own if you're alone. Preferably you pray with your family. And then we have usually time and speech or some pray sunnah. By then we say we are praying Taraweeh. Bismillah. We're going to finish the Quran inshallah online. It's myself and my two hafid assistants. We are praying inshallah. And we want to do this as a service, as we always do it, especially for the people up north, remote areas, some people in detention centers, some people in senior homes. They are actually listening to the Quran. So there will be the full recitation of the Holy Quran at the same time, Salat. And again, this is only something for necessity, and we are given this as a solution because people are so attached to the masjid and we're so attached to those people, and we're not seeing them this month of Ramadan. Hopefully things will change in the course of Ramadan, but as far as we are now, you pray your fard and you follow the sunnah. In Jumu'ah, same thing, you listen to the khutbah, inshallah, because of your intention, and Allah is the most gracious, you listen to the khutbah, and then after we finish, you go and pray your dhuhr, again, by yourself or with your family, preferably with your family. I hope this is clearer and simpler, and we have, if you want to see more, you have more detailed explanation in the last halaqah, which you'll find on YouTube and other, I believe, Facebook and other places. I wish you, inshallah, happy, prosperous, fruitful Ramadan Kareem. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.